eternal God, supreme commander of us all, Lord of the far-flung battle line, to whom the ranks of life report. We bow before you with reverent hearts and in sublime faith that you lead us on in death as you have in life. For again you have ordered a veteran to the realm of the West, beyond the twilight and the evening star, where beauty and valor and goodness dwell forever with the unnumbered multitude. Mindful of service nobly done, you have called our veteran to everlasting rest. You have sealed his lips with the faded blossoms of springtime and the withered leaves of autumn. You have called him to eternal peace, to the land of your silent mystery. Hear now the sorrows of those who mourn. Touch their tired hearts with healing. Protect them with your holy care. Keep clean and bright in memory the splendid flame that is now flickered out and shelters with passion. Amen.
This moment is sacred. With the most visible presence of the one who is gone, we've come to honor the memory of this man who offered his life in the service of his country, who is now enrolled in that great spirit army whose footfalls cause no sound. But in our memory, their souls go marching on. Proudly we remember their service in time of war, because of them the nation lives, and because of them the world is blessed. May the ceremonies of the day deepen our reverence for our dead. Let us not enshroud their memory with thoughts and sorrows. Tears or words of sympathy will not bring back those comfortable hands, for the sound of his voice it is still. Only a solemn pride in his service is for you and us to remember. Although I did not personally know the veteran we are interning today, we in the military regard him as a member of our military family, never to be forgotten. That is why the service of the day are in his honor. Be prepared now for military honors. It will consist of a rifle volley with three rounds. It will be quite loud when it starts, followed by taps in the folding and presentation of the flag. If you're in civilian attire, the proper etiquette is to render the hand salute during the service. Other than that, I suggest you place your hand up your arm. If you'll please rise now for military honors. Please be seated.
Mayor, on behalf of the President of the United States, the United States Army, and a grateful nation, please accept this flag as a symbol of our appreciation for the most honorable and faithful service. My deepest condolences to my family.
These three shells represent the three values, by the way, the code that you love on the duty on this piece of paper. That's what it's called. If you and your family do it, we and you do it, which is all three of them.
On behalf of the President, our Director, and all the staff here at Florida National Cemetery, it's my honor to present the Presidential Memorial Certificate in recognition of the faithful and honorable service that your loved ones gave to this nation.